Wow. All right. Okay. All right. So we are in the final part of week four. The training is muscle endurance training week. Help the body to build up muscle strength plus endurance. So this is the final workout of this style. We're going to be doing four sets timed. It's all lower and back. I'm also going to be able to get deadlift weights off of people today. Mike, if anything is revolved around hips, which I have a couple things, you will just do either seated leg curls or leg extension to substitute those. So the first thing we're going to do is squats, barbell squats to the rack. So it's not very low. So you'll see over there, Michelle, move out of the way a little bit. They're just going to squat down to the racks there. So it will be above parallel. This is just to get the hamstrings, which hamstrings are needed for deadlifts. So we're going to be doing that for 40 seconds. Then we've got sissy squats on the leg press. So you get on the leg press, you'll bring your feet close together and hanging off the top of the rack, and you're doing little sissy squats on there. So again, quads, hamstrings. I've got two people, so I'm going to make them do three exercises, and then we'll switch exercises. Then number three, band around your ankles, and this is side lateral, hands out, and you're doing a lateral with the band around your ankle. So this gets your quads very intense for the quads. So I have this here for you to sit down, put that on, and you'll be doing that. So we'll start with the squat and this, and then number three will be the leg press, the sissy squats on the leg press. All right, so we're going to get started now. So set your, if you're not going to squat with a barbell, set your leg extension up, have a band ready. If you don't have a band, you're just going to do this movement with no band. So that's all you're going to be doing, just walking all the way in one direction, then walk all the way back in the other direction. And then leg press. If you don't have access to a leg press, you can do wall sit. So everything is usable. So just do a wall sit if you can't do leg press. And then if you can't do squats and you don't want to do sit and stands, then you're going to do leg extension. All right. So let's get started over there. I'm going to move the camera closer so we can see them easier. All right, Rachel, you put the band around your ankles over there. You'll get started right there. And Michelle's right here on this rack squat. So go under it, put it on your, where's the band go? Knees, it won't feel heavy. Ankles. We'll be moving our weight up as we go. Okay. And just take one step back, and you are going to touch all the way down on the racks and explode up. Okay, so you touch down on the racks and you explode up. And then bang. Yep. And you don't have to come off. You don't have to come up off your toes, off your heel. All right. So 40 seconds per location. Go. Yeah. All right. I'm going to get the music back on. Rachel, make sure you come to at least where Michelle is, so that way the people viewing can see what you're doing as well. I want them to see both of you in the middle of this. Yeah. Get your butt down lower. Up down low. How much more time you got? You got enough. 8 seconds. 8 more seconds. Yeah. These are the two exercises we're doing today. We have four rounds of this. All right. Move it. All right. Wrap that.
You are
going to
get back hurt. You're moving over here.
I don't like that.
All right, go. 40 seconds. So our exercise number three, if you look at Rachel, she's doing a sissy squat on the leg press. Sissy squat on the leg press.
And you just go down on dominating with one side, and when you come back, you dominate with the other side.
Yeah, good. Keep your arms all the way out, Michelle. Yeah, straight out. Yep. It's full dominance on your hips here. Full dominance. 20 seconds to go. 20 seconds to go. There.
chopping balls, I'm smoking line off the moles, money holes and clothes, all the bigger holes.
Last one. All right, move it. All right, Rachel's coming over here to the squat. If you are at home and you're doing all three of these and you move a little bit faster, you got four rounds to do. All right, so you're squatting there. When you bust out of there, you bust up real aggressive. Okay. And the weight will move up after the reset. So go down normal, but explode on that. Yeah, so kind of slam down, explode up. All right. Stay down low, Michelle. Keep a sissy squat. And they're sissy. Yep. Yeah. Good. Good. Okay. Make sure you can see her again. That's how your squat looks. Hit racks and then explode up. Hit racks and explode up. Yeah. 20 seconds to go. Yeah. Keep your real small on the leg press. Real small. All around your knees. Hamstrings, all that. 10 seconds left.
Michelle, the longer you go, the more it burns.
I'm feeling it.
I know.
This is a burn from hell day. Here we go. Nice. All right. Starting round two for us.
I'm not going very heavy with you. If this feels like it's not close enough, we'll move up another notch. Well, I don't think we're going to be going up. Tell me how you feel. Let me try it. Not my thing. Not yet, Michelle. Not yet. You said, okay, see one before I get to five. I'll move it up. If I move that up a little bit more, I'll move your rack up a little bit higher. All right, ready? Here we go. Yeah. Okay, real low. Stretch that band as far as it'll stretch. Really get tension against your band. Yeah, explode. That looks good. All right, we got Rachel coming. Yep, you want to go high tension against that band. So push it out as far as the band will take you. Good. 15 seconds to go. Yeah, good. Find a land. Use way more booty. You land on there and then you bust out of there. That's a lot of butt. A lot of butt on that. 5 seconds. Good. All right, move along. I came back. You want to see my butt cheeks that way? You say the same. Okay, technicalities, Michelle. Do it the other way the next time.
You cheated your other side.
So we got 4 rounds. I'll keep them out the next time.
Dad, love watching grab walk on.
You were cheating on the acting last week. So.
Yeah, that's true.
I didn't call you out of that. But the video saw you.
You did at the end.
At the end, I did call you out.
Here we go. Next round. 40 seconds. All right, you see the sissy leg press. Sissy leg press. Yeah, good. Good. Yep. All the tension you got against that band.
Full length of the room, down and back at least.
15 seconds to go. Good. All right, ready? Here we go.
I'm keeping that weight on there for you, and then I'll switch it. Yeah, exactly. Neither one of you are going to go very heavy on this since you're not squatters. This is maybe for your deadlift. That's what this is for. So, and your long leg. I'll probably go one notch for the next two rounds. Good. Is we're going to three now? We're going to round three now?
Okay.
Round three now. Ready? Round three begins. Go. Yeah, good. Okay, starting on her other leg, coming down on the other leg. And I went up on the weight for them since they're not squatters and powerlifting. I moved the rack up higher for them. But this is for hamstrings for deadlifts anyway. If you're not deadlifting or squatting, you can skip that and do a wall sit instead. No movement of the joint. 10 seconds to go. Real nice. Those look good. Yeah. 4 seconds. Good. All right. Move it along. All right, go. Number two. Move number two. Stay low, stay high. Low and wide on the band. Had to do an AC/DC adjustment. There we go. All right. Found these out. Is this round three for you?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Boom. Explode. Yeah. Good. Oh, hamstrings.
We got to launch out of the blocks with hamstrings. We got to pull up deadlifts with hamstrings. We need those for everything. Nothing looks better than nice, developed hamstrings. Nice. 10 seconds to go. 4 rounds, 40 seconds today. Keep that sissy squat going on that leg press. There we go. Move it along. Are you back here?
Top of the floor.
All right, beautiful. Okay, so you have 150, 120.
No, you made it look so easy. I think 20 is easy.
All right. Ready? Here we go. Work. Oh, yeah, they're putting it to work. Burning those legs out. Burning those legs out. Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. Come from a dead stop. Ooh, how much booty that is. Looking good. 10 seconds left. Bravo. All right, here we go. Move two, round four, go. 40 seconds. Come on, let's burn those legs on that leg press. 60 squats from hell there. All right, here she comes. Side lateral, nice and wide. Side lateral. Inner thigh, outer thigh, and a lateral around the knees. Strengthen in the knees. Oh yeah, oh yeah. 15 seconds to go.
Let's wipe the show on your ass. That'll get your act ready. Coach of the year.
Coach of the year. She just gave you the award. All right, switch it up. All right, final part. The knees are done. Then we move to three more exercises. All right, I'm adding another two.
How can you not stay motivated with that?
All right, ready? Here we go. Final round. Stay tight. Real tight on that squat. Bang. Blast it up. Blast it up. Yeah. That looks good. Oh, yeah. You see both those moves happening. If you're at home, you have no access. Wall sit. Sit and stand. Leg extensions and replace them. 10 seconds left. Last one. Bravo. Done with that. Good job. All right. Well, we got our four sets done. Sometimes it takes longer than you guys at home. We're going to move on to the three new exercises. So, we've got deadlifts, barbell deadlifts. We got one arm rows. It's going to be a standing row. Looks like this with a machine. If you don't have a machine, you can just do one arm rows with a dumbbell. Then part three is wood chops. You can do wood chops with a band. We're going to try it with a band today. Or if you don't have a band,
You can just step on the band if you can't hook it onto something, a wood chop like that, or you can use a dumbbell and do wood chops with the dumbbell. But we are going to do a BAM.
All right, let's get this weight moved down and let's get it set up for deadlift.
You are not going to do your maximum deadlift today. You're just going to do a weight. We're going to get it up there towards the end. If you have deadlift shoes, put them on. If not, I would be barefoot. I mean, I'd be with socks on. I wouldn't be in a thing. There are some extra bags, bars in the back if you need to take any extra ones. We made a bin for the extra bags. All right, so we got deadlifts number one. We've got one arm row. We're going to do four rounds, so you'll be able to do the whole 40 seconds with one five. I want the arm up. You look like Usain Bolt. You're doing this Usain Bolt move. Test that weight. Make sure that's doable. And I might have to add another 10.
Yeah.
Too easy?
Yeah. No, it's very difficult.
Let me do it one thing. So you got this. You have this. And number three is over here. So Rachel, you'll have this one. Number three will be the one. Oh, I have that one. Okay. What did they do here? Why is that so low? All right, so if you're not deadlifting and you don't want to deadlift, you could do stiff legs. Then you can do dumbbell stiff legs, okay? Uses your hamstrings without your hips. But deadlifts are absolutely using the hips. Okay. All right, I'm going to show you this one arm row as well. Rachel, do a couple of those. Put the other arm up and you look like Usain Bolt. So you're opening up like this. Yep. Open up like Usain Bolt. Okay. All right, ready? 40 seconds. Let's work. This is a warm-up weight for Michelle. Many reps as you can get in. When we get towards the fourth round, might get one or two reps in a fast. This is the new style of powerlifting training that we're doing. I'm not doing a ton of each move. I'm doing all kinds of extra moves instead of just all deadlift, all bench, and all squat. Nice. 14 seconds left. Oh, yeah, that move is all helping throws over here. Helping throws right there with that. 5 seconds to go. Nice. Looking good. That's good. All right. You are moving over to wood chops with the band. You're moving over to those rows. So we've got a band tied all the way on that machine over there. She's going to be doing wood chops with that. One direction only, wood chop. Again, you could do wood chop with a band. You could step on the band. You could tie the band around something, or you can use one dumbbell in your hand. Rachel, show the wood chop again so they can see it on camera. Two hands on it. And we're going towards the door. Aiming towards the door. That's all we're doing. Towards the door. All right, ready? Let's go. 40 seconds. Yeah, other arm is up in the air, Michelle. And you look like you're staying cool. Yeah, bring it back. Yeah, beautiful. You are twisting that hip and that trunk. Yeah, good. Start to get your heart, strip the pad off. 20 seconds to go. Back to what the wood chop looks like. Yeah, beautiful. These are three new exercises, four rounds. 5 seconds left. Bravo. All right, let's move it. Rachel's up on deadlift. Okay, so that's got 125 on it. Okay. 25. No, that's not 125. Yeah, 115. That's 125. Yeah, all right. 125 for you. Warm up set. Many reps you want to get in. Here we go. Yeah, good. Nice. Good. Michelle, try to keep your arms straight. Yeah. And it's the most important arm is the one that's the right one, going that way. That one. So it's all this right here. 15 seconds left. When you are done, put it on the rack when you're done. Yeah. 5 seconds. And that's it. Bravo. All right. We're changing the deadlift weight. Getting ready for round two.
Getting ready for round two.
Everything shares 45 goes on. Got a 45, a 10, and a 5. 45, a 10, and a 5. You'll start putting the belt on after this set. Make sure you guys dry your hands up good.
All right, ready? Round two begins. Here we go. She's moving. 165 for reps. Good. Get your eyes up high, chin up high. Yeah, hamstring. There you go. You got to be up. Well, if that's all you're going to do, then that's all you're going to do. You got to be able to straighten out your legs, but yeah, you have to straighten out. You got to use those hamstrings to straighten out. You don't have to do a bunch of reps here. Get in what you can do. Yeah, you're looking down. The body will not work with your chin down and your eyes down. You got to push up with your head.
Straighten up.
That's good. Bravo. Good job. All right. We're moving on. We got wood chops and row. Here we go. Other side. Doing the Usain Bolt. Open all the way up. Open up that. Yeah. Pull it down, twist the hip and the trunk. Twist your hip and your trunk on that same bolt move. A one-handed row with a band, a machine, and if you don't have either one of those, you can always do a dumbbell one-arm row. 14 seconds left. Good. I love this song. Looking good. Good. Looks good, Michelle. All right, let's look at Rachel. Yep, got our wood chops going great. That's it. Good. All right. Lovely. All right, Rachel's up on the deadlift. 165 for reps. 165 for rep. Nothing today is going to be max rep. Nothing is max rep. It's just what can happen in the... And I'm progressively increasing the weight. I don't care if it's just one or two reps towards the end. You ready? All right, here we go. There you go. Yeah. So watch how our eyes are looking up. Got to be looking up when you pull up on a deadlift. If you don't want to do deadlifts, just do stiff legs. Yep. Use your hip joints heel and just use your hamstring. Good. Look good, Mike. Looking good. Nice, Michelle. Those look great. Oh, yeah. 10 seconds left. Ooh. Nice. Last one. There we go. Beautiful. Excellent. All right. We're going to switch the weights up. Belt's going on for 34 sets.
Seconds. I don't care if it's just one rep. You don't need to press for a lot of reps. There you go. Straighten out. Yeah, nice. Yeah, you're trusting that belt good. Yeah. Here comes that Usain Bolt move. Yeah. Good, good. She's got two. Damn. Looking good. Round three. Ooh, she got three. Wow. Lovely, lovely. I am looking for a lot of reps here. Do what you can do. Totally different powerlifting training. Oh, nice. That's enough for you. Good for you. Last one on Rachel. Yay. Bravo. That was excellent. That was excellent. Boom. There's no time for a thought. There's no time for fear. There's no time for anything. Your eyes are down. You take your breath. You look up. You go. All right, ready? Next 40 seconds. Here we go. Bottom of three coming up. Bottom of three coming up.
If you were my boyfriend, I probably would.
Rachel's going to be doing 300 at the next meet, so this little 205-ish, this isn't shit. 205-ish. All right. Ready? Here we go. Nobody's putting nothing but its clock on them. Nobody's telling them what to do. They pick up what they want to pick up. Yeah. Yep, I'm not putting reps on them. I think this style of training is going to change their lives come meet time. Good. I want way less work, plenty of recuperation. Yeah, I love it. Setup looks good. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Get those eyes up and she pulls. You got enough time. One more. That's it. Bravo. Good work. Good work. Have you been over 200 before? What'd you do with me? Oh, okay.
Perfect.
I mean, this is more than I really need you to do right now at this point. But if it doesn't budge, then I'm going to immediately take that off. Okay?
But if you can get one in 40 seconds, beautiful.
Beautiful.
So take a little bit longer time for your setup. Get all completely ready. All right, ready? Here we go. We are on three. Beginning three?
No.
Yeah.
It should be four.
Or four.
Four.
Beginning four.
Yeah,
beginning four. Okay. Start at four. All right. This is really a max set for her. If she gets one or budges it, that would be immaculate.
Oh,
she budged it. Shit. Wow. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. This is more than I wanted today. If you got another in you to do that same thing, I'll take it. Another in you to do that same thing. We got 9 seconds left. So if you want to do one more, you can. I do not care. If it just budges, we'll take it.
Try just get it above your knees. To your pants. There you go. Right there.
That's good. That's good. All right, let it go. Yeah, bravo. No need to hold it long. That was great.
That was
above what I planned for you.
Shoulders, but you're this close to being legal.
That's fabulous. Already?
You're way out. Good. Fabulous. No, you're catching up. You're going to be 300.
Bottom of four. Almost there. Middle of four. All right. Got the same bolt move. Yep. And we got the wood chop going down. Same bolt and wood chop. Good. Lovely. Rachel's max, but we're climbing. We're getting up there. Many reps as you can actually get in these 40 seconds is fine. Just pace yourself well. Pace yourself well. Making sure you pay attention to the details of the eyes up and you're using hamstrings. I don't want the low back involved. All right, let's wrap up the fourth and final move. Here we go. Nice. This is not a bunch of reps.
It would feel good.
Got some ACDC going on. Five seconds. She's going for one more. She's gunning for one more. There it is. All done. Bravo. Beautiful. Looks beautiful. Good job, girl. All right. We are going to head to the ground. Start doing some abs. All right.
Each other sitting down on the ground across from each other.
All right, if you have no partner at home to use the ball, you can just do it yourself. So they are going to do the ball toss to each other, so lay all the way down on a full sit up. I'm going to be calling out different moves for them to do over 3 minutes. Just a bunch of different moves.
So sometimes they'll set the ball down and flip over the planks. Sometimes they'll do full sit-ups. Sometimes they'll be throwing the ball to each other. But I'm doing 3 minutes worth of moves. All right. Let's start with ball toss. If you're at home, you got a ball or a dumbbell. Come up in a full sit-up. And then throw the ball and lay down. Yeah. Catch it and lay down. Yeah. You catch it as you're laying back. Catch it as you're laying back. Yeah. Good. Oh, yeah. Looks good.
Woo. This is all we got.
One more.
Oh, man.
All right. Flip over in planks. Flip over in a plank. Regular plank. Regular plank. Regular plank. Get right up. Get right up. All right. Toss the ball. Just roll the ball to the person's opposite arm. Roll the ball to the person's opposite arm. Yep. Opposite roll. Don't alternate. Don't alternate. No. No alternating. Stay right there. I'll tell you when to switch. All right, switch arms, roll the other way. Again, if you're at the if you're alone, you can roll the ball in and out if you want to, or just lift your arm up like Superman. Okay, back to regular plank. Flip over on your butt, seated jackknife. Sit on your butt. Put your arm between your legs. On the up. Yeah. Seated jackknife. Good. 90 seconds to go. You don't have to lay down on this one. Stay seated. Yeah. All right. Crunches. Plank crunch. Okay. Flip it back over. Back into plank. Person number one with the ball, put your hands on the ball. Off, on, throw it to the other person. Off, on, toss it to the other person. Okay, what you got? One, two, three, four, and then toss it. Yep. One, two, three, four, then toss it. Yeah, bravo. Two, three, four, toss it. Looks good. 45 seconds to go. Three, four. Toss it. Good. One, two, three, four. Toss it. Two more. Good. One more. Both people. Good. Back on your butts. All right. Lean back. Climb an imaginary rope and let yourself down. Climb up. Let yourself down. 15 seconds left. So climb up an imaginary rope, then let yourself down the imaginary rope all the way to the ground. 9 seconds to go. Good. They're going to take a break, and then we're going to do another 4 minutes. They went fast as hell today with just two of them, so I need more abs now. More abs. 4 more minutes of abs. Better grab a drink.
All right, this time on the ball, you got to really stay focused. One person catches the ball, toss the next one. It goes like a rotating circle. You are just leaning back, toss, catch, bring it back.
So there's another ball that's coming constantly. I got to see if we can actually make this work or not. With two balls. So you're not laying down in a sit-up. You're just leaning back, and you're tossing to the side. Okay. Put a ball to a side of you. Okay. All right. Toss that ball over there. No. You got to catch that first. Yeah, over on that side. No, it goes like this. Yeah.
So keep that down.
Yeah. I'm over on that side. Then come over to this side. Toss over on that side. I guess it's just one ball.
Oh, God.
Just one ball. All right.
All right, we're back on the ball. We're back on 4 more minutes of abs. So, again, you could use a ball. We're just leaning back. You could toss the ball or a lighter dumbbell up in the air and catch it.
Preferably a 5 or 10.
Keep it on the side. Keep it on the side.
Sorry.
Yeah. You're going to do about 5 more seconds of eight. 5 more seconds of eight. Last one. Last one. All right. Lay down. Jackknife. Laying flat. And bring, spread the feet apart. Put your arms between your legs. Yep. Down and up. Take your legs all the way to the ground each time. Full jackknife. Legs go to the floor. You go to the floor. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good. 15 seconds of these. You better be breathing. You need a lot of oxygen on jackknife. Okay, now we're going to do banana roll. You're going to banana roll over to the left. Do a suicide plank. Hand, hand, forearm, forearm. Banana roll back over. It's going to go back and forth. So banana roll this way towards me. Do a suicide plank. Forearm, hand, hand, forearm, forearm. No, it goes down, down, up, up. Banana roll. Yep. The other way. The other side. I would start on my forearms because you're making that way harder. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Banana roll. Go on your forearms. So then you can go hand, hand, forearm, forearm. Okay. All right, here we go. Banana roll into a suicide plank. Banana roll into a suicide plank. Banana roll is one roll on your forearms, on your hands, and roll the other way. Up, up, down, down, roll. There you go. Good. That looks good. Now you both got them. Sink in. Up, up, down, down, roll. Good. Up, up, down, down, roll. Looks great. 10 more seconds of these. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. 5 seconds. All right. Stay in a plank on your forearms. Stay in a plank on your forearms. 1:40 to go. Plank on your forearms. Keep breathing. All right, you're going to get up on your hands. You're going to take your right hand, touch your left foot over and over in a plank. Right hand to left foot.
Right to left?
Yep. Try to bring your foot up. Touch, even if it's your ankle. Touch your ankle. Yeah. It's the opposite. Opposite touch. 5 more seconds on this side, then we'll switch sides. Oh, yeah. 2 seconds. All right, do the plank on your forearms just to give yourself a breather. Plank on your forearms, give yourself a breather.
So restful.
It's so restful. It's so restful.
Like, you just get my fucking feet from sliding. That would be
helpful. All right, let's get back up. Opposite. Okay, now the opposite hand and foot touch. Go. Opposite hand and foot touch. Opposite hand and foot touch. Yeah. Good. Nice. Super advanced. Super advanced. Really got to keep your abs pulled in. 25 seconds left. You got one more of this. Flip over on your back. Crunches. Lay down on your back. Back to crunches. Back to crunches.
These are the easy ones.
Back to crunches.
You're really free.
You only have 10 seconds left. 10 seconds left. We'll start stretching out here. Yay. Bravo. All right, good work. All right, stay on the floor. Flip over on your belly. Put, stack your hands underneath your face and resting bitch face, face to the left.
I use that all day at work.
You're all stretching.
You did good. What did you do on your max lift? What was your max lift over there?
On the
one that you like.
Okay, let's do upward facing dog. Finishing? Up dog. Okay. Push up on your hands. Upward facing dog.
Yeah. It was close. Little adrenaline, some smelling salts.
Upward facing dog. We gotta stretch out. Okay, exhale down, stack your hands again, turn your head the other way. Relax, turn your head the other way.
can yell at you more if you want more motivation.
Come up on your forearms for the cobra pose. Up on your forearms for cobra. This just helps put the little roundness in your low back. Roundness in your low back.
I'm going to record my voice yelling at you and making fun of you.
Roll on your side, grab your foot, pull it to your butt. One foot, pull it to your butt. Roll on your side. Roll on your side, yep. All the way to your butt, grab a hold of it. Yeah. And roll on the other side, to the other side. Okay, back to up dog, back to up dog. Push up, look up, dig your toes into the ground, go to down dog. Toes in, down dog, spread your feet out as wide as your hands, flatten your heels down, feel a stretch all the way down your hamstring. I like advanced down dog, I like the heels down. Push on the floor hard, push on the floor hard. Feel the stretch all the way up your back waist to your low back. Exhale down to your knees, go into the camel pose. You can do one arm camel, get up, reach back, wrap one hand on your foot, other hand in the air, let your head fall. Push your belly forward like a capital D. Switch and do the other side. And if you've got one side easy, I want both arms back. Touch with both arms, push your belly forward, look back. Exhale, bend over into child pose. Forehead towards your kneecaps. Keep your feet close together. Your knees close together on this one. Yep. And then hands go to the sides with your palms up. Breathe nose and stomach. Now make your toes touch and spread your knees wide apart. Walk your hands out to the extended puppy pose. Hands go all the way out in front of you. Yep. Touch your chest to the ground and then touch your head to the ground. Straighten your arms all the way out. Yeah, this is a fabulous stretch. Groin, arms, back blades, everything. This is a great stretch right here. What?
I need a gumby groin.
Yeah.
I need gumby groin.
Oh.
I need like more flexibility or bigger boobs. Bigger boobs would be good too.
Yeah.
That would like.
Okay, flip over on your butt. Sit on your butt. Put the bottoms of your feet together. Grab a hold of your ankles. Lift them up off the ground. Yep. Cobbler pose in the air. Cobbler pose in the air. Control your weight. Control your weight. Again, we're working on body weight control.
My boobs are going like down and to the sides. Okay.
Put your hands on your right heel. Straighten it out to the side. Hands on the right heel. Or hand on the right heel. Straighten it out. Once it's out, then try to point your toe. Keep it under control without going back to the floor. Bring that back with control. Take the other one out. Take your time wherever you get control in your body. Once you actually open it, then you try to point it after you open it. Get all the shaking under control. Get all the shaking under control. It's all focus.
Timber.
Bring your feet back together. Rest your forearms on your legs. Take your hands on the outside of your knees. Smash your knees together. Yep, your legs are still up in the air. Legs are still up in the air. Hands go behind your knees. Straighten your legs up in the air. Take your time. Get them straight. One arm up, then the other arm up. Palms up. Take your time. Feel the balance before you move. Feel the balance before you move. Bend your knees and if you're too wobbly. Okay, bring the feet back together in the cobbler up in the air. Hold on to it. Get control. And you're gonna lay back and go to the baby pose. So lay all the way down. Take your right hand and pull the baby leg down to the knee down to the floor. So Michelle, grab like the top of your foot and press down. Try to press your knee all the way to the ground beside you. I do one at a time. I pull one leg down the foot, put your foot up like this, and faces the ceiling. Your knees bent. Yeah, like that. That one. Not that one. This one. Yeah. So it kind of looks like this before it's advanced. That's advanced on one side. Then go to the other side. Pull the other one down. Yeah.
Just trying to pull it down.
Yeah.
Now straighten your legs up in the air. Walk your hands all the way up around your ankles. So legs are straight up. Walk your hands, grab a hold of your ankles. Once you got your arms straight and your legs straight, pull your head up towards your legs. Pull your head up towards your legs. Stretch out the backs of your hamstrings. Okay, sit all the way up, straighten your legs out, bounce your knees. Straighten your legs out, bounce your knees. Cross your ankles, both hands go on the bottom foot. Grab a hold of your bottom foot with both hands. So your legs are straight out in front. Cross your ankles. Both hands go on the bottom foot. Behind the knee, hamstring stretch. Bounce your knees again. Switch the order. Yeah. Other one. Okay, you're going to work on balance and strength. Bend both knees to the right. I've done this one before with you. Both knees bend to the right. If they're bent to the right, your right hand's in the center. Left hand is out to the side. Push your body weight up off the ground. Everything comes up off the floor. All right, try it. See if you can do it. Yeah, even if it's just a split second. Good. Both of them up. Yeah. Do about five of them. This is a isometric level of strength. Sometimes people can't do their whole body. They can lift their front leg. Sometimes people can lift their back leg only. Once you do five, then you're gonna switch the order. Remember, you gotta push on this part, the meaty, strong part of your hand where your knuckles are. Push right there. Yeah, good, you're getting up. Flip your legs the other direction. Do the other way. The position of your hands is everything. So you really got to get, I put that hand over there by my hip. Yeah, that outside one. Yeah. Yeah. Because you want to balance both these hands.
Oh. It was so charming.
Yeah, of course.
My ankle never there, though.
That's normal.
Like here and at the bottom of my foot.
But, hello. Do four more. Yeah, good. It's your flexing so good. Again, we're working on body balance and isometric. Can you move this body weight with little tiny muscles?
There's
one more. Okay, let's stack the legs, the Lincoln stack, the Lincoln log stack. So one leg is bent and set the other leg on top of it. Or do the Lotus if you have the capacity, do the Lotus. So set that. That one, that's fine. Yeah, like that. Yep.
Okay.
And then do arms across your chest. Just get your shoulders stretched out and your pecs. Yeah. What's not letting you? Is that your knee?
It's everything. What? This Charlie horse I gave myself on that last move.
All right.
But it's also just tight.
And are you tight here?
Yeah, it's not helping either. But that's not, I haven't even gotten to that. There's too much going on.
But your hip is tight.
I'll come sit on your lap.
Switch the order of your legs the other way. Lift that one up, put the other one on it. See if one works better than the other.
Nothing wants
to
work. Because now this one's pushing
on this. Again, is this your hips? Or is that your knee?
Mostly hips right now.
Okay. And then do your arm the other way. Stretch your pecs the other way.
That's so funny. I thought my hips would be so tight, but this is like super easy.
And then finish with your neck. Forward and backward. Make sure your arms are down at your knee level when you're doing your neck. Arms are straight down. And then do ear down to shoulder. Ear down to shoulder. Loosen up, oh my God, all the way down those traps. And hold it in one spot where you feel achy. And then go to the opposite side. And then the last one, chin to your shoulder, chin to your shoulder. Good. Excellent. Well done. That was excellent. Great recovery. Great work. Awesome work here.
All right, everybody, we'll see you tomorrow. If you're going to be in boot camp, 11:15, throws and jump fails, 12:30, Sunday, 9:15, and then Monday, the only session is 10:15 a.m. All right, everyone, see you later. Bye, Mike.
So how much was that for one?